Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? Actually, I'm kind of sore. After a month of hiatus, our fitness class started up again today, and I did not exercise once during the entire month off. I'm paying the price for it today. Now, while I did not exercise my body over the last month, my brain was working overtime, and I will share what I've learned in that time with you today on Dotto Tech. Ask Dotto Tech is the show where you ask questions and I do my best to answer them. Now, you can ask me those questions in Twitter, you can ask me those questions in Facebook, or you can ask me those questions on YouTube. Now, the first question that we have actually came to us via Twitter, and it's from Ms. Volpel, who says, I need to send a video to family that is over 20 megabytes. I think she's referring to her video, not her family being over 20 megabytes. I can't send it in a text or Gmail. What can I do? Well, I actually have a suggestion for what you can do. Why don't you think about saving the video to YouTube and then using a YouTube link to share it with your family. Now, there's a few things you're gonna wanna do. Because it's family video, you probably don't want it posted for the entire world to see. So you're gonna wanna set some privacy settings on YouTube. But you can protect the content on YouTube so that nobody else can see it. And then you can use YouTube as basically your distribution medium to get it to your family. It's quite simple. Now, I have here my personal YouTube account. When you create a YouTube account, you're going to need a Gmail account or a Google account in order to create your YouTube account. But once you create it, you want to go into the area called Creator Studio when you are in YouTube. And Creator Studio will give you this thing here called a dashboard. The dashboard is where we manage our videos. We determine how much privacy there is set on those videos, and we can do other things with those videos as well. But I'm going to first of all show you the process of uploading a new video, say your first video, and then what you want to do to protect the privacy, and then how you find the URL, the link, to share it with your family. And I think this will be a good solution for you. So the first thing that you want to do is just to upload the video. And you can click right up here. When you're in the Creator Studio, the management area, you have the upper right-hand corner, you find the ability to upload. Now you can just drag videos and drop them here, or you can click here and you can navigate to your videos the way that you would normally navigate to any other file. So I'm just going to grab a video that I have here, which is a nice little video I shot on the iPhone of our niece and my partner having a nice playtime. This is the sort of personal video that you might want to use. So the first thing that you're going to do when you upload the video is you're going to give it a name. See, just this process of selecting it has started the process, and now you see it is actually uploading to YouTube. But worry not, because it's set here at unlisted, meaning unless you share it, unless people know to look for it, they won't be able to find it. And you can actually make it so they need a password to find it by making it private. But I think unlisted will probably do for the most part for you. Now what you can do is you can give the video a name, and I'm gonna call this Fun Times, because it's playing with the child, and then you can give it a description and you can add tags if you want. These things are more for videos that you're gonna be sharing with the public than private, so you don't need to worry about them. The next thing you do need to worry about, though, is making sure that it is set at unlisted. And by it being unlisted means that it's not gonna be available to the public unless they know it's there. Once you've done all of that, you can say done, and then you have to kind of sit back and wait, because it's going to take a few moments for the entire process to happen. Now, what's going to happen is over the internet now, your video is being taken and it's being uploaded to YouTube. Once it reaches YouTube, YouTube will take it and it will compress it and it will compile it so that it's ready to share it and serve it. Now, YouTube has hundreds of hours of video being uploaded to it every minute. So yours is just another one in the queue. It doesn't take very long for it to happen, but it does take a few moments, a few minutes, depending on how large and how long your video is, for it to be successfully uploaded. Now, when you just start out, if you have a free account and you haven't set yourself up as a YouTube partner, like you're doing business with YouTube, you'll be limited to probably, I think, under 15 minutes for a video, but still plenty of time. But you see, this video is already up and it's ready to go, and it even has a thumbnail in place, and you can actually share it right from this point if you want. But I'm not going to recommend you do that. However, I am going to ask you to notice this URL. This link is something that you can now share in an email or share in a tweet, which will allow your family to view the video from YouTube, even if they aren't logged on or anything like that. They can just click on this and the YouTube video will play. When we click on return to editing, that's going to take us back into the editor. Well, actually, let's just go here and let's go back to the Creator Studio. And now we see the video uploaded in Creator Studio. And here is where we can go in and we can really get granular about what we want to do with it. We can click on the edit button right here. And then that will allow us to go into the video in the full editor. And this is what I do with all of my videos that we upload. The video that you're watching right now, we do this on our main channel for every single video. And we go through the video, we add thumbnails, we add descriptions and all of that sort of content to it. But here's where you can go to view it to make sure that it's all in good shape. And here's where you go to change the sharing settings. Right now it's set to unlisted. If we go to private, in order for people to view it, you have to share it with individuals and only they will be able to see it. It will be based on them actually logging in. So for the, as I say, for the most part, I think if you just leave it as unlisted, you'll be fine. Again, we have the URL that you can share. And so if we put that URL into an email, let me just go in and let's create a new email and show you how this might happen. I'm going to paste that URL into the video. And now if somebody is to was to click on that URL, this is what they would see. They would be brought to a YouTube play page and you'll see the video just for your family or the people who you want to share it. Now you'll notice that comments are disabled on this video. If you want your family to be able to actually go in and comment on it and be able to make little comments, you go into your advanced settings here and you turn on allow comments. And then all of the people who you're sending it to can tell you how awesome it is to have the video shared with them. So there you have it, Mrs. Vopel. That's how you can share larger videos with your family by texting or emailing it to them. The next question we have on Ask Dotto Tech comes from John Boyd, and it came to us in YouTube comments. Now, John had viewed the video about my three favorite Gmail add-ons, and he says, maybe a bit of guidance how to install these add-ons into Gmail. Thanks. So I was remiss in not doing that, John. I'm happy to share that with you. Let me show you how you go about adding those add-ons into Gmail or indeed into any web browser, because that's exactly what happens. We don't actually install any add-ons of the sort that I was showing in the Gmail video. We don't actually install it in Gmail, but instead these are things called browser extensions, and they work the same or relatively the same on all of the major browsers. So here I am in Chrome, which is the one that I used in the demo, and all you do to add any of these extensions is you go into your preferences within Chrome. And once you go into preferences, you will see the extensions option right here. Extensions are where we turn on and off our different extensions. Now, typically speaking, those extensions will appear here in the browser bar. So you can see the ones that I have turned on, all available to me here. Now, sometimes though, they'll just appear in the Gmail window itself. Now, if you want to add new extensions into Chrome, you can do it in a variety of different ways. But the easiest way is to go into this menu here, click Get More Extensions, search for the extension in the Chrome Web Store, and then when you find an extension that you're interested in adding, let's say it's going to be, I don't know which one it's going to be, let's say Turn Off Lights. I don't even know what Turn Off Lights is. They all work the exact same. You click here on Add to Chrome, and it installs it in your Chrome browser. It's just that easy to add the extensions. So that's how we extend the functionality of browser-based tools like Gmail. Now, I know you're wondering, this is great, Steve, but how do I do this in Safari? Because I'm a Mac user and I use Safari. Well, let's just open Safari. In Safari, we have Safari extensions and we have preferences, two places that we can go to work with our extensions. Safari extensions brings us to a web page where we can search for and install our preferences, but the preferences is where you go to actually manage them. Now, I don't have very many installed in Safari, but here I can turn them on and off just as I can in the Chrome browser. Very similar process, just a slightly different interface. Not to be left out, let us take a look at Firefox. And Firefox works with extensions pretty much the same, but slightly differently. Firefox, we find our extensions under the tools bar in add-ons. This brings us in and allows us to manage all the extensions the exact same way as we manage them in Chrome and in Safari. So there you have it, John Boyd. This is how you install your add-ons for Gmail into your different browsers. Well, I hope you found today's video to be useful. Now, there are three ways for you to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. The second is I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter. That way you'll hear about our upcoming trainings, tutorials, and different courses and offerings. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel. We're supported through the generosity of you folks at the crowdfunding site Patreon. I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page, have a look, discover what supporting Dotto Tech entails, and what perks are available to you. The perks are awesome. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.